Hello and welcome to Cal Poly iPad Support. This video is going to show you how to use your iPad's accessibility settings. Accessibility provides several unique and convenient options to make the iPad experience easier for those who have issues with seeing or hearing. First on the list is VoiceOver. This is a gesture-based screen reader that will describe everything happening on your screen and is very helpful for users who have trouble reading the screen text. Touching or dragging your finger around the screen will prompt VoiceOver to tell you what's there. You can tap a button to hear a description or double tap to activate it.
Speak hints on.
Any element on the screen you interact with will be highlighted in a black rectangle so you can easily follow along. You can also adjust the speaking speed and language of the VoiceOver. Next is Zoom. This option is good for people with the same sight problems but don't want to have to deal with the noisiness of VoiceOver. With this turned on, double tapping on the screen with three fingers will instantly zoom in 200%. Drag three fingers around the screen to drag the area that is zoomed on. Double tapping on the screen and then dragging three fingers will adjust the zoom between 100% and 500%. The next option is Invert Colors, and this does exactly what it sounds like. It inverts every color on your iPad, even in videos. Aside from just looking really cool, this function works well when trying to read when there is a lot of glare on the screen. White text on a black background pops out a lot more and is much easier to read. Speak Selection adds another option when highlighting text besides the regular copy, cut, and paste. With Speak Selection on, you can highlight any amount of text and have it read aloud to you.
iPad support is awesome.
Next is Reduce Motion. iOS 7 uses a parallax effect to create the perception of depth on your home screen. This is why your app icons will appear to float above the background wallpaper, and they all shift slightly when you move your iPad or iPhone. The only issues are that 1, this actually uses up a lot of battery, and 2, if you are prone to motion sickness, this may cause dizziness or nausea. So if any of these problems seem relevant, the reduce motion option is right for you. This turns the parallax effect off, and it also makes the home screen transitions fade instead of zoom. So those are most of the visual aid based options. Next, there are those for the hard of hearing. In subtitles and captioning, you can set your preference to closed captions and SDH, or subtitles for the deaf or hard of hearing. With this on, if you are ever watching a video with subtitles available, they will automatically be turned on for you. When you're using headphones, you may miss some audio if you're deaf or hard of hearing in one ear. This is because stereo recordings usually have distinct left and right channel audio tracks. Turning on mono audio will play both audio channels in both ears, and you can adjust the balance for greater volume in either ear. Unless you have a Bluetooth hearing aid device, that is the end of hearing aid options on accessibility. The last thing I'm going to go over in accessibility is the accessibility shortcut. This gives additional functions to your home button when you triple click it, so you don't have to go to settings every time you want to change certain functions. Selecting any one option will make triple clicking the home button instantly activate it, like so with Invert Color. Selecting more than one option will make triple-clicking the home button bring up a menu from which you can select your options. And that's all that's left for your iPad's accessibility settings. If you have any more questions, don't hesitate to go to ipadsupport.calpoly.edu.